With independence, we inherited a system of education which was not only meager in its reach, but it was also marked by the persistence of large intra and interregional as well as structural imbalances. Only 14% of the population was literate, and only one child out of three had been enrolled in primary schools. The low levels of participation and literacy were aggravated by sharp regional and gender disparities. Mahatma Gandhi considered education as a tool for the development of consciousness and reconstruction of society. Stress was accordingly placed on reform and restructuring of the educational system as part of state intervention. Though the parliament is empowered to legislate on education, the centre has been relying on a consensual process to promote educational development. The concept of concurrency was given an operational meaning by the National Policy on Education, 1986. This policy envisages concurrency as a meaningful partnership between the centre and the states, and placed on the union government a larger responsibility in regard to the national and integrative character of education. Quality and standards, manpower planning, research and advanced study, and international aspects of education, culture and human resource development. Birbhum is one of the relatively smallest districts in terms of population in the state of West Bengal. As per 1991 census, its population is 25.55 lakhs. The literacy rate is 47.1%. A total literacy campaign for Birbhum district was approved by the National Literacy Mission in December 1990, and the campaign was launched in February 1991. A survey was conducted in which 7.30 lakh learners were identified in the age group of 9 to 50 years. The district has a large number of illiterates from the scheduled castes and tribes, which is almost 53% of the illiterates. Against 7.30 lakh targeted learners, 6.57 lakh learners were enrolled. According to the findings, the district had made 83% of the targeted learners literate and is currently under post-literacy phase. This district was one of the 8 districts shortlisted by the Government of India for consideration for the UNESCO award during this year. This district was, however, not recommended for this award, as another district in the state, that is Burdwan, had been recommended and won the award in 1991.
Director General of UNESCO is visiting West Bengal and Birbhum district to see for himself the progress of the post-literacy work which is now in progress. I am also very proud that the Vishwabharati authorities has decided to confer on him the title of Deshikottam.
In the educational sphere, great advances have been made, but it is also ironic that while great scholars have been contributed by this university and many other high seats of learning, nearly 49% of the people of India are still today illiterate. It is in the fitness of things, therefore, that this university now has also decided to water the sources of knowledge in the shape of taking an active part in the literacy campaign that is now almost sweeping the entire nation. Here, in these hallowed precincts, I am mentioning this because I am sure the mango grove under which Gurudev showered his blessings on those who gathered around him is the fittest place to say that we in India are totally committed not only to the pursuit of knowledge by the elite, but of trying to provide the poorest of the poor in the huts and hamlets spread all over the country. We are committed to light the lamp of literacy so that the awareness that it generates gives the people of this great country the strength to overcome the obstacles that still lie in the path of their manifest destiny. That Dr. Federico Mayer is being honored here with the conferment of a degree is only natural, because Dr. Mayer, not only as the head of the UNESCO, which is in a way the conscience of this world in the field of learning, culture and science, but in his own personality has all the qualities that a person should have as the motivator for the world community to progress and accomplish what human beings are made for.
In recognition of your great qualities, Professor Dr. Federico Mayer Zaragoza, I, as the Upacharya of Vishwabharati, confer on you the degree of Desikottama, Doctor of Literature, honoris causa.
Education for all means education by all. Education for all means all devoted to education, all for education. What represent the universities in this movement? As an integral part of the education system, the universities are clearly called upon to contribute directly or indirectly to the education for all movement, as to the national development effort as a whole. They have a very important role in providing all the society with guidance and criticism. The universities must be the conscious of their society.
After the convocation function in the morning, we proposed to take Dr. Zaragoza to two villages near Bolpur, where he will see for himself the kind of work that is going on in our district. But before that, he will be given a reception in a public meeting where we expect at least 5,000 to 6,000 new literates and other volunteers in this great human task. You are aware that Dr. Federico Zaragoza has come to India in view of the Nine Nations Summit in Delhi, which was held recently, where a very important decision has been taken that by the year 2000, the curse of illiteracy is to be banished forever. As part of this program, we have undertaken a mass literacy campaign for the last few years all over West Bengal, and Birbhum has been one of the success stories. It is also our privilege that accompanying Dr. Zaragoza will be the Director General of the National Literacy Mission and other officials from UNESCO and from the Department of Education, Government of India, and from the Mass Education Department and Directorate, Government of West Bengal.
I, on behalf of the people of Birbhum district, West Bengal, India, welcome all of you present on this august occasion. We are very much glad to have you in our midst. Your presence to the mass literacy centers will be a great inspiration for all of us, and your valuable observations will help us to make the total literacy movement a success in the district. The planning and development process and programs in West Bengal are primarily aimed at the development of human resources. This includes total education, healthcare, and employment generation. The main thrust lies with the total education program. To achieve this end, total literacy campaign gained priority. With the participation and involvement of the people all over the district, we have been trying to reach the goal. The clarion call, Education for All, and the commendable role played by the UNESCO, cooperation and help from National Literacy Mission, India, and help from various other organizations inspired us to work in this difficult field. We are grateful to UNESCO and all of you. Hope your help, cooperation, and advice will always be with us. I again thank you all.
Phire chal matir tane, je mati achol pete je ache, mukher pane phire chal matir tane, je mati achol pete je ache, mukher pane phire chal matir tane, jar buk phete pran utheche, hashite jar phul phuteche re, jar buk phete pran utheche, hashite jar phul phuteche re, dag dilo je gaane gaane, dag dilo je gaane gaane, ei phire chal phire chal phire chal matir tane, je mati achol pete che ache, mukher pane phire chal matir tane.
Thank you. Dr. Meyer, Birbhum, which literally means the land of the brave, have really been waging a really valiant battle against illiteracy, ignorance during last 2-3 years. It has written one of the best chapters of literacy movement that is going on in this country through the National Literacy Mission. They have achieved a very, very difficult task of making about 600,000 people literate in a period of 1 year, mobilizing volunteers, more than 50,000 volunteers for this effort during this period. You have already heard the role played by the academics, by the officials and others ever since you have arrived this morning. But more than anyone else, it is the common people of Birbhum who have made this movement possible and have achieved what they have achieved. Now, Birbhum is entering into a very exciting phase of post-literacy work. I am reminded of a famous line of a poet whom Your Excellency is very familiar with, Pablo Neruda, who, talking about his own poetry, there's a beautiful line that my poems have not eaten poems, they devour exciting happenings. Similarly, literacy does not feed on literacy. Literacy must be about exciting happenings, about whatever is happening around us. In the post-literacy phase, I am sure the Birbhum Zila Sakshata Samiti will make the literacy an instrument of real empowering of people here.
I would make just one or two points in this regard. The first is that in our country, I have a feeling the literacy campaign remains very heavily dependent on government support or the support of a few non-governmental agencies. Tagore had given a good deal of thought to this, and he used a concept, what he called Atma Shakti, or the concept of self-help. And the main point he made was that if enlightenment and the spread of literacy is merely an attempt from above, it will never be successful. It will never become a self-sustaining process. I hope and trust that we shall be aware of this danger. We have to make our effort self-sustaining by generating the kind of motivation that is necessary for the beneficiaries of the literacy campaign to carry forward what has been initiated by governmental and non-governmental agencies over the last 2 or 3 years.
আমরা যখন ইউনেস্কোতে হাজির হই, আমাদের সেই বৈশিষ্ট্যকেই প্রশংসা করা হয়েছিল। আমাদের সার্বিক সাক্ষরতা আন্দোলনের যে কর্মসূচি, সেই
When we first went to UNESCO, they highly praised our plans and also showed respect to our total literacy program. And as you know, that the government of West Bengal, as a representative of India, has been awarded the NOMA Prize.
NOMA পুরস্কার তারা আমাদেরকে দিয়েছিলেন।
I came here today to tell you three things. The first is to congratulate you. The second is to thank you. And the third one is to tell you that I love you. Why I congratulate you? I congratulate you because you have achieved a very important target. You, the learners, you, the volunteers, you, the teachers, you have accomplished a very important target for human dignity. Literacy is enlightenment. Literacy is empowerment. And it is for this that you see all these flags, all these white flags with the emblem. What we see in the emblem? We see this symbol that is the symbol of joy, is the symbol of victory, is the symbol of freedom, is the symbol of giving. Therefore, congratulations. But I said that I also came here to thank you. To thank you on behalf of all the United Nations system. This system of nations that are united against poverty, that are united to not tolerate what is intolerable, the disparities that exist today in the world. It's for this that I thank you, because with your effort, you have done a very big jump in this way, in this path for human dignity. Close from here, Rabindranath Tagore told us that we cannot get peace if we accept what is unacceptable. And poverty and marginalization, all these are the threats that today, and you have been able to face these threats, and it is for this that I thank you today. I told you that there is a third reason to be here, apart of congratulating you and thanking you. I told you that I love you. And I said this on behalf of one organization that is the intellectual organization of the United Nations system that must express their love and their friendship to all those that have been able to overcome the obstacles to become elite, to become literate, to share the knowledge, to have access to the knowledge, to the heritage of the past and the heritage of the future. I like to express particularly my appreciation at all those that are already adults, because they have said, no, it's not too late to learn. Never is late to learn. It's always too late to be illiterate. It's never late to learn and to make this effort that you have done. And those who love, share. Those who love, give. As a token of my appreciation as Director General of UNESCO, I would like to tell you that I will provide $25,000 to help this campaign in all the targets that you have today still to accomplish. I would like to provide this money to all these authorities in India, in this district, in this state, that are making possible this very important achievement for your country. I thank you. Has been said by the Director General, by the Minister, by the Vice Chancellor. Now you can understand better why I congratulate you, why I thank you, and why I love you. Thank you very much.
Zaragoza would be taken to two villages, Raipur and Kakutia. The program is that at Kakutia, he will be inaugurating a model post-literacy building which we call in our district Shikha Chokro. We have given several post-literacy books to these centers, and we have quite a number of such centers running throughout the district. But at Kakutia, a new building has been constructed with the help of the Sriniketan Shantiniketan Development Authority. After his program at Kakutia, we will be taking Dr. Zaragoza to Raipur. Where he will be visiting a non-formal education center for children in the age group of 9 to 14. Here mainly children who are engaged in economic activities and are unable to attend school, they are given certain inputs.
And as the Director General, I go throughout the world, to all the countries, to all the villages, saying that the human rights are not for some privilege, but for all of the
Do you think after today that you have spent some time in the remote villages of Bengal in Birbhum district, do you think this gives you added confidence that EFA is achievable?
Yes, I am absolutely persuaded. I was before, because I knew, according to the UNESCO's World Report on Education, for example, that the trends are much better than they were 4 or 5 years ago. There are many people talking about the impossibility of redressing the situation. And when we know the new threats, poverty, massive migration, the pollution of the environment, many people say, well, this has no remedy. It's not true. Today in India, in West Bengal, I have realized that it's not true, and it is feasible, and that I am sure that by the year 2000, we could say that this was not an utopia, that this was one venture that we have there, and that you deserve, all those, the learners and the teachers, they deserve our congratulations.
মুখের পানে ফিরে চল ফিরে চল ফিরে চল মাটির টানে দেখতে ওই দিগন্তরে ফুল রয়েছে পাতা জন্ম মরণ ওরি হাতের অলোক সুতোয় গাঁথা ও সেই অলোক সুতোয় গাঁথা দিগতে ওই দিগন্তরে কোল রয়েছে পাতা জন্ম